What's up guys, welcome to 27 Lanes. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about my all-time favorite running gears and accessory. Just to say it, I am not being sponsored by any of these brands. Everything that I'm going to share with you today, I have purchased with my own money and I have tried it myself. This is just my opinion of what works for me over time, but you're welcome to look into them. I will leave all the links in the description below, so you can go ahead and check that out after the video. And yeah, let's jump in the video. So my first item will be this little fella right here. So this is a shoe clip light. You could definitely clip this to any shoe. You put it in the back of the shoe, and this is great if you're running late at night or if you're running early mornings while it's still dark. Safety comes first, always. As much as you can, try to put yourself in the most safe situation when you're running out there. You want to make sure that people see you, the car sees you. The way that it works is that you put it in the back of your shoe. You know what? Give me a second. I think this is better. So you can really appreciate it now. So definitely you clip it in the back of your shoe. You have two settings. One setting is this one. And then you have this setting, which is faster. And then you turn it back off. Simple as that. So that makes item number one. And the lights are back. My next item will be the Nathan Zipster running belt. I have used this belt for like the past 6 years. I use this belt literally on every run, every race. I cannot be without it. I'm able to fit my phone, the GoPro, my keys, even gels for when I do the races. I mean, it's pretty spacious. I mean, it has four large compartments, and then out of the four, two have a zipper. So even if you want to make sure that your phone is secure or anything, then that you just don't want anything coming out, which it's not. Anything really is not going to come out. But if you really want to be secure, this is definitely a great belt. I like it that it doesn't roll up or like in the middle of the run, you have to like constantly adjust it. You just have to make sure that you get the right size for you. I'm usually a small. I purchased the extra small and it's pretty snug, it's pretty tight. So this is a great buy. I highly recommend it. Really, I cannot stress it enough. So this is top item for me. My next item on the list that I could not be without is my running watch. So I've mentioned before that you do need a tracking system. Some people like to run by feel, and that's okay. Personally for me, I need the data. I need to know how am I doing, how's my pace, the distance. I need to know how's my heart rate. So everything really comes from this watch. I've used it for the past 2 years. I literally use it on every run, every race. I mean, I need it. This is like my bestie right here. So I think this watch is great. I mean, it does have a heart rate sensor here. I don't think it's 100% accurate like that. I mean, I think it's somewhat accurate, but if you really need something where it just tells you about your pace and your distance and all of that, then this is a great watch to have. The price range is about 160, I think, since it's an older version. And obviously there are way more expensive watches. There are less expensive watches, but this is my buddy right here. And with this watch comes my item number four, which is this thing right here. So this is by Road ID. This is called the face plate. You could put this on your watch. They have different ones. You could put a bracelet, you could put it on your shoe, you could put it whatever you want really. But I have the one that comes in the watch just because I know I have the watch all the time. And this is great for you to put your information. God forbid something happens to you, you faint, something happens, you're out there on the road, somebody happens to see you. They could call your emergency contact. Definitely, I recommend it, especially if you're a woman and you wanna make sure that you have something on you that's able to identify you. This is what it is. And my last item is sort of like a two for one, which is this foam roller right here and this one. This is called the Tiger Tail foam roller. This is the grid foam roller from two separate companies. I'm leaving everything linked below, don't forget. But the difference between these two is that this one, I like it more for maintenance. And then when, you know, you're home, you're able to foam roll at your house. I think this is great. I like this one in particular because you can carry it with you at all times. So anytime that you run, You can just have it in your car, put it in a book bag, and you're able to use it as soon as you're finished with your run. Also, if you're traveling, I think this is better. It's more convenient that you can put it in your luggage. It doesn't take up too much space, but you're still having some sort of foam rolling. You could use it in your legs, you could use it in your bag. So I normally lean towards this one a little more just because of the practicality of it. But this one also, it's great just for maintenance and to have it at your house and just to foam roll when you're home and when you just have that space to have it around. All right, guys, so this was my favorite running gears and accessories. Gotcha, I have one more for you, just because I like you like that. Bonus, Vaseline, my friends. Vaseline is a game changer, and I think this is something that every runner should have, and it's also the least expensive one. Honestly, Vaseline is the way to go. The way that I use it is I put it in between my toes, especially when I'm doing long distances, anything between 8 or 10 and up. I have to put Vaseline in between my toes, outside of my toes, on my heel. I mean, just lather your whole feet with Vaseline. It's really going to help you, and it's going to prevent blisters. Also, if usually for the ladies, I use it under my bra here on this area here. I usually put it right on the area of the straps because I tend to get shafting as well. You could put it like on your shorts, right on the back of your shorts, just that area that is, you know, after 10, 12, 14 miles, your skin is gonna feel it. So, and for the fellas, también, oop, my Spanish came out. And for the guys, you know where you can use this as well. I heard that it works. Now, officially, we're done with the video. These were my favorite running gears and accessories. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you guys found it useful. Let me know if there's anything that you have to have, no matter what. I would love to hear from you. If you're able to purchase anything and you try it, let me know how it goes. And like always, don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the notification button so you never skip a video. And I'll see you guys in the next time.